Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Jimmy here with the CLT Life Home Team at Costello, here with your real estate minute today. So keep up with me with the real estate blog. If you go to bit.ly/JimmyGRE blog, you'll see our daily updates with the real estate blog. So today's topic is why this is not like 2008 all over again. And it talks about the Great Recession of 2008, which was caused largely by the housing crisis when we had lots of foreclosures. It was pretty much brought on by the mortgage industry and predatory lending, when banks were giving money to people that shouldn't have had loans in the first place because they didn't have the assets or the income or the credit to be able to continue to afford those loans. And now this financial crisis that's gone along with the current pandemic, like it says, it caused hardship in certain industries and hurt many small businesses. You saw more in the restaurant and retail sectors. And it hasn't rattled the world economy like 2008 did. And now that about a year later, things are starting to get back to normal, especially with restaurants opening back up at full capacity and people being able to get back in and go out and do things and spend money. So what happened in 2008? I love this graph, and it's kind of scary. It shows bank failures by year from 2007 to 2020. So these red numbers right here, this was 2009, 2010, 11, and 12. So back here before, you know, in the early 2000s, when banks were just giving money away to people who wanted to buy houses, you know, more and more people became homeowners, but they couldn't necessarily afford those homes. And then when they stopped making their payments, then the banks had a problem. So we actually, a lot of the banks, the biggest banks, got relief through the TARP program, which was the Troubled Asset Relief Program. So in 2008, the government, they saw the foreclosure meltdown as a top-down problem and set aside $700 billion for banks under the TARP program. And not all $700 billion was used, but the important point here, as it says, is that the government back then, they looked at it as a top-down problem. They dumped more money into the banks. They were deemed too big to fail. The banks that caused the financial crisis in the first place were actually bailed out. This time with the pandemic, money was given to small businesses through the Paycheck Protection Program. People got expanded unemployment benefits, tax incentives. There was forbearance that was opened up for people who couldn't pay their mortgages to try to keep them in their house so they could delay payments for a short time. And a lot of people, you saw the stimulus, all the different stimulus acts and stimulus checks that we've had as well. So a lot of people have actually received some money paid directly to the people. That's helped people out as well. Obviously it's $1,400 here, $700 there. You know, it helps a little bit in the short term. Might not keep people on their feet forever, but it has helped out, and they've kind of turned the way with this crisis, the approach was different. Instead of dumping money in from the top down, which I'm not sure who you would pay with the pandemic, but they supported individuals and families to help keep them on their feet. So long story short, we're not headed for another 2008 like housing crisis. We do have supply and demand issues for sure. It's a super seller's market right now. Just means there's a lot more buyer demand than there is seller inventory available. So, but it does seem that as we enter June of 2021, it does seem that more buyers are finally starting to feel a bit more comfortable putting their house on the market. I think what's concerning a lot of people is just trying to figure out, okay, well, once I sell my house, where am I going to go to next? So, there's like three times as many buyers than sellers, I would say, out there right now. There's a third fewer, and I base that on, there's a third fewer homes in the Charlotte market available for sale now than there were this time a year ago. But I think we're going to start trending back up a little bit before too long, to where hopefully home values, they'll continue to appreciate. But for the buyers out there, you know, they've gone up. I think they've gone up, like I saw a stat, it was over 12% year over year home value appreciation. And that's just not a sustainable number, especially for affordability for people to be able to come in and buy their houses. So hopefully, you know, this upward trajectory that we're on right now, hopefully it levels off a little bit and then stays on more of a sustainable upward slope. I don't think that there's going to be a huge drop off. I don't think we're going to hit a peak and then all of a sudden home values are going to dip precipitously before they start tick-tocking back up. I think we may hit a point where we hit a high mark and then come down just slightly and then bump back up again. But anyone who's had a house for a while, who's been in a home, even for a year, a couple years, you've seen your home values go up and you're not going to lose that, that extra, equity that you've gotten in your home. So thanks a lot for watching the Real Estate Minute, which I know was about 5.5 minutes with Jimmy G. And I look forward to doing more of these more often. So again, you can always see my blog here. It's at bit.ly/JimmyGREblog. It's also posted daily on my Facebook business page. So just look up on Facebook at the CLT Life 704. I'm going to post these videos on Facebook and YouTube. So subscribe to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/theCLTLife. And we also have an Instagram channel, two Instagram channels, @theCLTLife704 and @theCLTLifeShop. So you can look cool in your CLT Life gear. Thanks so much for watching this, and we'll see you on the next video. Take care.